Hey everyone, it's Brian, back with another RWD screencast. Today we're going to be talking some more about Phaser. We're going to be looking a little bit more in depth at creating tilemaps and how we incorporate those into our program. We're going to be using a new piece of software here called Tiled. Tiled is basically just a application that we can use to import a spreadsheet, use it as a tile set for a map, and then generate a JSON file that's going to be consumed by our Phaser application to produce a map. I'm just going to quickly take a look at this tiled application and show you what this is capable of here. So I'm screwing around a little bit with this here. Let's just clean this up a little bit. So you can see what this application does is it allows you to import a tile set, and you can import that tile set. You can define some certain things about it. You can pull this in. This is a PNG file, which I called world, which is part of the library of sprite sheets that we've been using throughout the course of this tutorial series. And I set the tile width and the tile height so that the application knows exactly where each new tile starts and ends. And we create a map. The map, again, uses the same tile size, width, and height. And we define it as 20 by 15 tiles, which at 24 by 24 gives us a canvas of 480 by 360, which is exactly the size of the screen that we're working with in our application. And this is going to allow us to create a layout here that has a perimeter which we can surround with a wall, which we can later use as a barrier to prevent our character from moving any further, and then just some different tiles to it gives some just a little bit of more detail and a little bit more character to our game here. A couple of things that I want to point out here. When we import our sprite sheet here, every one of these tiles is going to be given an ID. So when we place one of these tiles on the screen, that ID is going to be passed along to our Phaser application, so we'll know exactly which tile we're referring to in our application by the ID that's exported out when we create our map. And we will go ahead and we would do a save as, and then we can save this as TMX or as a JSON file, or we can export it, and we can export it to, again, as a JSON file or as a CSV file. We're going to take a look at what those exports actually look like here. So here in our maps folder, I've exported this out in a couple of different formats. TMX, which is the default format for tiled, which is not really going to be relevant for our game, but is relevant if we want to go back in there and edit our tile map later on. Room1.json here, which has the data stored for our tile map, but it's encoded, so we can't really take a look at the contents of it, but we can see what the name of the tile of the layer is, and you can have multiple layers within a tile map. This way you can have like one layer which is the background, one layer which is the foreground, etc. But we just have one layer, and it's called tile layer 1. And we can actually look at the CSV file, which gives us a little bit better understanding of what actually comes out of there. So remember I said each of those tiles has a ID associated with it, and you can see that it's actually just creating a matrix of those IDs in the CSV file, which tells us exactly which tiles are mapped to which location on the screen. So 223 up here corresponds with this corner piece, and 218 or 221. 218 is this wall 221 is this wall, and the game will be able to interpret this and be able to display it appropriately. We then have to, in our load.js, we need to pull these tile map and image files in. So we're going to load the tile map. We're going to call it level, and we're loading it from the assets maps room1.json, which is that file that we were just looking at over here. And you'll see here that Phaser actually has a format here for tiled.json or tiled underscore JSON, which is very helpful because this way Phaser will know exactly how to handle that this file here with the encoding and all of these additional variables on here. So very useful. Back in the load.js, we have the similar to what we had to do with the characters, we have to load that PNG file in, and we're going to load that as with a name of tiles, and we're going to pass in the location of this, which is in our assets sprites world.png. And we could take a quick look at that. You could see that this is the same PNG file that we imported into tiled. So very important that we keep those consistent so that when we export from tiled, then when we load it into Phaser, Phaser is going to be able to map those files, map those sprites accordingly. So once we've loaded that in, we now have access to that within our play.js. So in play.js, we're going to create a variable called map, and we're going to add a tile map using Phaser's game.add.tilemap. And we're going to pass the value of level, because when we loaded this, that's what we named our tile map here. And then we are going to add a tile set image, and we are going to So we're going to call it world, and we're going to load it from the tile set that we loaded in our load.js that we call tiles. And now here, well, actually, this was our original game without the tile map. We actually have to go and what I've done here is I've added in a layer into our playState object. And we need to make reference to that layer in the scope of self. And we are going to create a layer. And remember I said that we need to be cognizant of what we called the layer in our JSON file. This is where we're going to pass that so that it knows which layer we want it to render. So if we had multiple layers within that JSON file, which we can easily do with tiled, we can create multiple layers. So let's save this. And let's refresh that. And there we go. Now we have a background, but if you remember before, the reason why we put these walls around the perimeter was so that we'd have something that would stop our player from being able to walk off the screen like that, and that's what we're going to do next. So similar to what we did with the sprites over here, we're going to set collision detection on our layer as well. And since we've already created an object called map, we are going to And that map is a tile map. It inherits the set collision function from the prototype, and we can pass an array of numbers into that set collision function, and that array of numbers is going to correspond with the tiles that we want to be impassable. So we have 217, 218, 219, and 221. If we look at our CSV file, 218, 221, 218, 221. So these are the tiles that are along the perimeter of our application. The other two are these ones over here, 219 and 217, which are these two that are at the doorway over here. So what's that going to do? That's going to indicate to Phaser that collision detection should be handled on these particular tiles. Then down in the application itself, we can, the same as we did with our mob, we can create a collision detection callback function for the player and for the layer, and it's only going to execute this function when the player interacts with a tile on the layer that has the set collision. That's one of the tiles in that array there. And basically what we're going to do is we're just going to call the self.player.stop. And I just want to make a quick note here. I made a change since the last screencast on this stop function. In the last example, we actually had set the velocity of the player to zero. Now I'm just setting the, I took that piece out only because it caused the player to kind of get stuck if we had that in there. So now it just sets the X and Y destinations to its the player's current X and Y destinations. And that prevents them from getting stuck. So let's take a look at what that looks like. Let's refresh this. And now it does exactly what we expect it to do. It stops him at the sprites. It also stops him from being able to pass those walls. And as you can see, there's a doorway over here, and he has no problem passing through that doorway, but he can't pass through any of these walls here. Hopefully this helped you to understand Phaser's implementation of tile maps and layers. More than happy to discuss this on the YouTube channel or on Twitter at IgnoreTuition. Always looking for feedback, so you know, please let me know what worked, what doesn't work, what you might maybe like me to cover in some future screencasts, and appreciate you tuning in. All right, thanks, have a great night.